Scares you, and I thought our fans kind of pushed us over the edge for some momentum there in the game. Georgia Tech, Brent, a lot of credit to their staff. You know, staff that's changed over, and they've worked really hard this year at putting game plans together, and you can tell they've done a lot of work. They did a good job defensively, and they did a good job offensively with their game plan. I got a lot of respect for their staff and their players, the way their players competed in the game. I thought special teams came through today. It's the first game in quite a while that we made some plays in special teams to kind of give us some momentum and get us rolling. So proud of that. But all in all, it's on to the next one. Great regular season for this group. They've done everything that we've asked them to do, and they only get bigger from here.
Was it a little emotional for you tonight to see these seniors take the field for the last time, just all that you've been through?
I don't know. I think I've been through more emotional ones than this one for some reason. This one just seems so fast and rushed. We were trying to fly through there to get through them. We got started a little bit late as Tech got off the field a little later. And I have to catch myself from stopping and spending too much time because you start having memories of sitting in the home, convincing kids to come. You see the first year, second year you've had them. And now, you know, this group's meant so much. I mean, look. Is it 46-5, Claude? What's the number?
46-5.
Yeah, this group's 46-5. How many games did we play COVID here?
10.
We did get 10 in the bowl game. So we only got 9 regular season games, right? And then the 10th was the bowl game. So we got shorted one game in a year that you were already shorted games. And they still came out the winningest group to ever do it. And it, you know, their leadership is our consistency, meaning everybody's like, well, how do y'all come out and do it each week and not let down and not do this? Well, their leadership is our consistency, and each and every one of them, from walk-ons to scholarship players, is deserving of the recognition.
Coach, can you speak to getting everybody's best shot week in and week out, finish the year undefeated, you know, ahead of the game next week?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I think everybody gets our best shot week in and week out. You know, it's not like, you know, everybody's like, well, okay, you're the target, you're the hunted. I don't believe in all that. I think that it's about us being the attacker, us being the aggressive. We probably didn't start as fast today as we have in the past, but you're not going to start every game, you know, just guns a-blazing. And we had to respond to some adversity once again. And, you know, probably should have had a bigger lead at half, but the way things fell, it just didn't happen. And they actually did a good job shrinking the game as well.
Vince Dooley tie, and could you imagine coaching on the sideline in a tie like that?
Well, I was going to, and I chickened out because I had a distraction from the seniors, and I didn't want all them saying, well, we don't change uniforms, why did you? So I decided to wear it to the press conference if things went well. But I told Derek, I asked Derek if I could, and Derek and Miss Barbara were both like, oh, we'd be honored to let you have his tie, and this is the tie he wore for so many games. And Derek gave it to me, and I probably don't do the sweater and shirt the justice that he does, but out of honor to him, no visor, and he did it right for a long time, and he meant so much to this community that it's just a small token of my appreciation for all the things he's done for University of Georgia and Athens.
Kirby, you guys only gave up 1 yard of offense in that third quarter. Just what do you think of the defensive performance, particularly after halftime?
Well, we played much better after the half. We made some adjustments. They did a really nice job. I mean, look, I got a lot of respect for Chip Long, Brent Key, Jim Chaney. Those guys know football. They didn't just forget football. And not only do they know football, they know us. And that part was good for us to make some adjustments and do some good things and come out and get our offensive ball back.
When you have that slow start that you alluded to, I mean, how fine is that line of kind of allowing that to fester or maybe even spin out of hand as opposed to what you guys were able to do in the second half?
You know, I think it's sticking to the plan. It's going in not knowing what's going to happen. You know, we talk all the time about we're going to try to outscore our opponents in the fourth quarter and win the fourth quarter every game. So the first thing we go over when we come in next fall is how many fourth quarters did we win? Well, as you guys know, there's some fourth quarters that we're already ahead in. And it's like, does the fourth quarter matter? It matters at Georgia because it doesn't matter who's on the field. We want to try to outscore them in the fourth quarter. that helps give you confidence that no matter what happens early, you're gonna be okay, and you have to keep chopping. Don't hit any panic buttons. They're doing a good job. I mean, the more times we snap it, the more advantage we think we got.
Kirby, it seems like came back and talked, had been playing some of his best football over the past two games. Just in your opinion, what's allowed him to be so good, kind of going back to that fumbling his fourth?
Well, he's been good all year. It's not like been a when he flips the switch and really starts going and gets rhythm. He's got great vision, great hands. He's a weapon. I hate that he's been through the year, you know, a little banged up. He's been beat up. He's had missed practices. He's had deep thigh bruise. Often he had two different ones, and so it's like, man, you know, can we lessen his load and lower the burden on him to try to keep him fresh? And it's been hard.
Kirby, you said the game's going to keep getting bigger. How do you feel about your team heading into that kind of stretch?
I'm excited to see our team. You know, I think it's much easier to coach on a week like this week than it was a week like last week. You know, there's just it's different, you know. Another week is Thanksgiving. It's not my favorite vacation. I like to eat, but it's tough because there's a different schedule. You know, there's a lot of variables that you can't control. And you know what? Ricky can't control them either. So it's not like I'm saying it's an unfair advantage, but you lose a routine as a coach, and it worries you a little bit. And I like the routine that we keep when school's in, with our normal schedule. And I'm looking forward to see our guys prepare for LSU, who's got a really good hot football team.
Zion Logan, Norman Jones, both did the game. Any updates on them and their status?
Not sure.
Is there an area of the game that you feel like you've seen the most amount of improvement since the beginning of the season?
No, I don't know that I've seen. I mean, it's up and down, right? It's all relative to who you play against. So you can say, oh, they've gotten so good at this, and the next week, it's not there. You know, it's a model of consistency and making sure you're good in every area you can be in. And there's no area that we can't improve on. I mean, let's be honest, we've got a lot of areas we need to improve on.
Can you recall, I think as you told us before the night of the national championship game or somewhere before, you ran into Coach Dooley on the elevator right before that? Can you retell that story with us?
Yeah, I talked about it the other night at his event, but he was, you know, he was, when I got off on whatever floor it was in Indianapolis, 15, 16 floor, things deemed. I was tired, I had my briefcase bag, and I was by myself headed to my room, and he was sitting right dead in front of the elevator, like sitting there. And I was like, what? Like, this is strange. Like, why is he here? Why is he sitting here? And he was waiting on his son to come back up with a key. So we shared a couple minute moments. I kind of waited on his son to come back up with a key and just thought, God put him here, so I should talk to him, see what's going on. And I just thought it was a sign. Before the game, but looking back now, not about that game, just about spending time with someone with that much wisdom, and just thought it was interesting to be there that night.
What happens now with the tie? Does it go back to?
It makes it Derek, man, or to the dude. Daniel and Derek got there for us, and I don't know what they'll do with it. This tie's got a lot of victories under his belt, though. I know that they've won a lot of football games. Claude probably was here for every one of them.
Coach, is there any lesson that you may have taken from Coach Dooley, or you know, one specific thing?
Just honor and dignity that he represented this place with. I always want to leave it better than you found it, and he did that to a degree that's unmatched. I mean, he came in when this place was really down, and he really put this place on the map. Laid a foundation for all of us coaches that have followed him. And he did it with class and dignity. And he always won with that, and he always lost with that. And he always represented the University of Georgia the right way. Just such a kind, knowledgeable man.
Kirby, it seemed like after a couple of missed opportunities earlier by Keeley, he kind of settled in as that game went on. Just what did you make of how he was able to kind of bounce back?
He made some good plays, and he made some tough plays. He got targeted a lot. You know, I have to go back and watch the PIs. I can't really say. It was a couple of them on their sideline, bang-bang plays. I mean, you feel like in our league they're going to let them play. And the PIs, the pass interferences, were like their best conversions, you know. But he made some nice plays where he turned back shoulder. He got a ball out over our sideline. And, you know, he continues to work. He understands playing out on that island, guys, is tough. You get targeted a lot out there.
Stephenson said, this was his second senior day today. Said he wasn't a big fan of it. What kind of impact has Stetson had on this program in his time here?
incredible impact. He's a leader, he's tough, a competitor. He's just been around, it seems like forever now, and he embodies our team with his competitive toughness. And he's got to keep doing the things he's doing for us to be successful, and we know we got to play better on really all three phases, better than we did today if we want to get where we want to go.
Kirby, I know you guys got a lot of film study between now and SEC championship game, but just kind of thoughts on Brian Kelly, what he's been able to do at LSU.
Yeah, he's an incredible coach. He's an incredible coach when he's at Notre Dame, and he's an incredible coach at LSU. And I know he came to this league because he wanted an opportunity to play the best, and he wanted opportunities to go to playoffs and win SEC championships. And he's at a storied place that's got a lot of tradition and history.
Following up on Stetson, a couple of players also said what you just said. He's the embodiment of what this program is about. What does it do for a team to have a player that is kind of universally regarded as representing all those values?
That's great. It's just tremendous. And it's not Stetson, guys. This game's not about Stetson today. This game's not about me. This game's about the seniors. Look, that's part of the reason I didn't put this on, because I didn't want the senior thing to be about that. I want the seniors to be appreciated for what they did. And I know he's part of that group, but there's really almost three classes within that group of seniors that look, they've been through some tough times, some great times, and it's not easy to play at the University of Georgia and hold the standard that we hold you to every day of practice, and they've towed the line.
One of your seniors that wasn't able to play, Nolan Smith, but he still made his impact, made it with the sideline warning. What does that say about his
Well, he actually got all of us, so we're just, I think it looked like it was him, but it was all of us, and as long as he's excited, I think I'd much rather have to coach the excitement out of him than into him.
Kirby, how'd you feel about your red zone offense, your goal line offense today?
I don't, kind of indifferent. There was times that I thought we did some good things. Sometimes the execution was there. A poor decision by one or two players affected us. But I was pleased with our field goal kicking.
How about a guy like Jack Podlesny? What does he mean? Obviously, you called him, I think, Mr. Consistency the other day. But, coming in today, he hits two, three. Just what has he meant to the program?
Well, he's meant consistency. He's insurance policy. When you play really good defense, your field goal kicker matters. Your field goal kicker doesn't matter when you don't play good defense, and all of a sudden you're having to score touchdowns every time. And Pod's given us that resiliency and really reliance. We've relied on him heavily in some tough moments. Thinking back to Missouri and Kentucky, he did some good things today.
Kirby, I know you don't pay any attention to college football playoff rankings, committee comments, and all that, but South Carolina knocks off Clemson today. What does that say about the league in terms of where it's at and maybe how it should compare when those final rankings come out?
I don't know what that does. I know that the South Carolina is a really good football team. I mean, I got to watch them play Tennessee last week. I mean, what they did is pretty incredible now. They scored how many possessions in a row? It's just crazy. And that's hard to do on air. And they did it against the defense. And they're playing really good football right now. Shane's doing a good job. So I know I don't need college football playoff committee or any person to tell me what the SEC's like. I was born and raised in this, and I know how good it is. I know how physical it is. I know how hard it is to play in this league week in and week out. It's tough and physical. Now, everybody always wants a piece, and everybody wants some of the SEC because they talk about it, and they don't play in it year-round. So it's different when it comes to bowl season, and it's a one-game matchup. But if anybody want an invitation, they can come play in this league. It's tough.
Let's take two more questions.
Coach, you guys seem to be running counter at a really high rate. I mean, is this something that's evolved as the season goes? You guys feel comfortable running it?
We think some of our backs run it well. We think our offensive linemen run it well. It complements some of our play actions. It's a physical identity type run, and a lot of defenses don't like playing it. It creates a lot of contact. Contact is what we're about.
What's to say about this program when you have guys like Vlad, Brock, and Stetson, who maybe weren't super highly recruited, but now are doing what they're doing and performing well in the SEC?
Well, I think it just shows that we evaluate. Look, those three guys were all good football players in and of themselves. They don't need verification from a service to say they're good. They're not looking for that. They're looking for an opportunity to go play with teammates, and they love football. And you wish you had more guys like that, because for them it's not about their stats. wins and losses. It's just about camaraderie and playing. And that's what I love about all three of them.